Hello guys, and welcome to Guitar Interactive Magazine. My name's Tom Quayle, and today on review, I've got this rather fantastic Vigier Excalibur Special 7-string. Really beautiful looking guitar, as you can see. This is from the French company Vigier, as I was saying, and it's a custom made, i.e. you can customize the model to your own specifications within a certain set of parameters. And it really is a phenomenal instrument in every respect. If you know anything about Vigier, you'll know that they pride construction and quality and playability really over everything else. And when you buy a Vigier, you get basically a fantastic instrument. So let's have a look at the construction and the hardware, so on and so forth, and then I'll let you hear what this beast sounds like. And before I do kind of play it, I'll just say this is way more versatile than it looks. Before we do anything, don't just consider this to be a metal player's guitar or some kind of shred beast guitar. This actually will fulfill quite a lot of your needs if you're a versatile player as well. So that said, let's have a look at the instrument. So first thing you'll notice is the Vigier kind of standard headstock design, but obviously slightly extended to fit the 7 tuners and slightly wider as well. I've always been a fan of the Vigier headstock. I think it's got a very nice sort of mixture between very modern, pointy, and nice and softly contoured. This slightly wider design isn't thrilling me quite as much as the original, but obviously there's a functionality here. The extra mass here is obviously going to give you slightly more sustain, and the fact that you've got to fit the 7 tuners on. It doesn't matter which company's 7-string you buy, it's inevitable the headstock's going to be a bit larger, but it is still a design that's one of my favourites as far as guitar manufacturers go. Vigier logo looks great, nothing too flash. There's a little bit of flaming going on inside the maple, but nothing too crazy going on. You've got some string tree style adjustments here just to keep the strings as straight as possible. Then turning over, okay, you've got really high mass, high quality locking tuners. Very, very, very nice indeed. And then you can see, this is the really cool bit running down the neck. If you know anything about Vigier guitars, you'll know that they are constructed from 90% maple, in this case, for this particular guitar, with also, this is a one-piece neck, there's no fretboard on here, it's a single piece of maple, with a skunk stripe of carbon running down the center. It's a 10% carbon neck, or 90 to 10 ratio. And what this does, basically, it replaces the truss rod and means the neck is incredibly stable. All the Vigiers we reviewed in the past have had really, really stable necks, and this is no sort of different in that respect. But obviously with a 7-string neck, it's slightly bigger neck, you want that stability, which is offered by this kind of construction. Really, really good. Okay, moving down, we can see the bolt-on construction that we've got here. Really, really beautifully made. Absolutely no flaws anywhere to be seen. Looking at the body, we've got, it's an opaque, older body. So it's finished in this kind of black, again, very sort of velvety black, beautiful finish. Turning over, okay, let's have a look at the body and the neck. Quite a kind of understated look for the particular neck of this guitar. We've got black inlays, sort of medium-sized stainless steel frets. Stainless steel is great because, and if you're spending this much money on a guitar, you're gonna want stainless steel, because stainless steel frets, not only do they last longer, but they also have a slippier kind of feel, which is great for vibrato and for bends. I really couldn't live without stainless steel frets now. I think they're fantastic. And right up at the top end here, we've got the zero fret, which is a kind of standard thing you'll find on Vigier guitars, which is great for sort of intonation. And what looks to be like a tusk nut, although I'm not entirely sure. So moving down, we've got 24 frets with very plain kind of black markers. It's a classy looking guitar rather than being a kind of overstated shred guitar. And then the body, this has to be one of the nicest flame tops I've ever seen. It's a trans charcoal effect with scraped binding. Hopefully you guys can see the scraped binding going on around the sides. It's again, a real classy look. It doesn't kind of scream a particular kind of overstated sensibility to you. It's just a nice looking instrument. Beautifully bookmatched with a very thick kind of flame going on. Very similar to my own personal guitar, actually, so I'm particularly fond of this. Floating non-locked trem, which works really, really well. Very good tuning stability, even though there's no locks at the top of the nut here, which is great for me because obviously I have to retune the thing, so that worked out really well. We've got Dimarzio Blaze pickups. All three are Blaze pickups. Obviously we've got humbucker, single humbucker. Five-way switch allowing for lots of different tonal combinations, including splitting some of the coils on the humbuckers. And then we've got volume and tone and a kill switch, which is kind of cool. So just to really quickly demonstrate the kill switch, because I can't really do anything too impressive with it. Okay, so that's really, really useful. If you're good with a kill switch, a little bit of practice, you'll get that down. Lots of creative potential. So, all in all, a beautiful guitar. Construction, absolutely flawless. Fretwork, flawless. The setup, again, I'm going to use the same word again. The action is pretty much slammed here, and there's virtually no buzzing. On my seven strings that I own myself, there's loads of buzzing on that low B. This is really, really, really well set up. Absolutely brilliant. Okay, so on to tones. What I'll do to start with, I'll just let you hear the clean tones. And my personal opinion of this guitar, and this is in no way a bad thing at all, it's just the way I hear this instrument. It's quite a dark sounding instrument, okay? You're not going to get kind of real brash, bright tones out of this. But of course, you could EQ your amp to run sort of more treble or more presence on your amplifier to compensate for that. But you'll hear now, I've not changed anything on the amp. We just kind of set it and leave it for all the guitars, so it's the same setting. This is actually quite dark. So here's the neck pickup, clean. I'll let you hear the low B and play a few chords to let you hear the clarity. Okay, great sounding pickups, these Demasias. I have these in my seven string as well. So here we go. So whilst they are quite dark, there's a lot of clarity in the notes. They're fairly high output pickups, these, and they will clip the front end of your amp if you're not careful. It's clipping a tiny bit here, the gain stage on the front of the amplifier. But no big deal, it's a really, really nice sound. Obviously you can roll the volume up to compensate for that. So just have a listen to the same kind of thing with the volume rolled off a little bit for a bit more clarity. Okay, if you've never played seven string before, it's a little bit confusing. I'm a kind of seven string. I'm not exactly an aficionado with this stuff. So it's a little bit more confusing, but once you get used to it, it's absolutely fine. So you can hear the clarity there in the neck position. Let's move down one. Now what this gives us in this second position is we've got the single coil from the neck plus the single coil from the middle. Okay, so we've split this single coil, humbucker into a single coil, and we get this sound. These are much sort of thinner sounds that you can use for a variety of different tones, actually, and they still sound really cool. So we get something along these lines. So again, a thinner sound, but again, it's good to have the versatility of that real thick sound from the neck humbucker and then the kind of more single coil sounds from the other variations. Now, when we're in the middle position here, position number three, we've got a single coil from the neck and the single coil from the bridge together. Okay, so we're getting kind of an out of phase-y kind of sound. Okay, moving down one more position. Now we've got single coil from the neck, the bridge, and middle single coil as well together. And then finally, in the bridge position, we have the bridge humbucker on its own. Okay, sounds like this. Okay, so those are the clean sounds that are available to you, and you do have nice range from broad, kind of very warm, fat sounds on the neck position, range of single coil tones, and then obviously with that classic kind of bridge humbucker kind of sound. Lots and lots of variation here, very, very versatile guitar. Okay, let's move on to the drive channel of the amplifier and try the same thing. This time we'll start with the bridge position and then work our way back up again. Okay, so obviously this is a high output humbucker, a seven string humbucker. It's meant for very heavy overdriven tones. So let me play you some power chords and a little bit of lead from this particular humbucker. We'll be right back. Okay, so very fat, very cutting at the same time. Really, really nice humbuckers. I mean, obviously, Damasio humbuckers are pretty much as good as it gets, so you know you're getting quality here. And if Vigier are going to put it in their guitars, it's got to be a great pickup for seven-string guitars. And it does sound superb. So, moving on, let's go to position number five, as it would be, and have a listen. Sorry, position number four, I should say. Okay, now middle position. Okay, let's have a listen to how this sounds. And then next position, so position number two. And then finally the neck position using exactly the same sound. So again, even with the overdrive fairly high like we've got here, it's still very clear. Very clear, you know, the clarity of the guitar is superb. And it's a very versatile sounding instrument. It's not just something that you're gonna use for hardcore kind of death metal kind of sounds. It really works in a variety of contexts. You could even use it in a jazz context if you're a seven string jazzer. So beautiful looking instrument, very, very easy to play. Just gotta get your head round that seventh string if you've never played one before. Again, that's always a bit of a challenge for me because I'm used to playing six strings, but it's great fun, offers a lot more creative possibilities, of course. And all in all, a really superb instrument. It's got that custom edge to it that you want from a higher end, more expensive instrument. And of course, there are some customizations you can have for yourself. You can change the finishes, you can have a rosewood fretboard if you like, so on and so forth. So lots and lots of variation that you can sort of customize to your own spec. So go and check one out. Vigier guitars are fantastic all around. This is their seven string, you know, one of their seven string models. So if you're after a seven string high end, you couldn't really get a better choice. So, hope you've enjoyed the review, and I will see you next time.